Hello, everybody. I'm Leora Sims. Welcome to my channel, and welcome to part 8 of my Sims 4 Law and Order SVU series. If you missed any of the other episodes, please go back and watch them. Before I get back into gameplay and storytelling today, I'm going to talk about self-esteem, confidence, and learning. When I was a kid, I spent a lot of time feeling stupid. I hate that word, but that is how I felt. I got good grades, but I had to spend at least 8 hours a night on homework. And I knew that my classmates were finishing a lot faster than I was. And they finished their classwork a lot faster than me as well. I hated elementary school. I hated junior high school. And I hated high school. But I knew that things would turn around for me once I got into college. When it was time to think seriously about universities, I began to look at scholarships. I wanted to receive a lot of scholarships. But I didn't apply for any scholarships because of one thing. Each of the scholarships that I wanted required a language. They had a language requirement, which meant that a student had to take 2 years of a language, had to study 2 years of a language other than English. I have a very difficult time with math, and all of my extra time was spent on math. And any time that I might have had the opportunity to take a language class, it conflicted with a math class. I needed the math for graduation. I was told that I needed to have studied a language by the end of college, but that I could graduate high school without the language, although it wasn't recommended. But what could I do? I needed the math. I needed a lot of extra math and a lot of math tutoring. So I didn't have time. When I got to college, I enrolled in a Spanish class right away because I wanted to get the language requirement out of the way. Over the years, I had convinced myself that I was bad at languages. And I thought that if I took a language class, it would cause my grade point average to plummet, and then all of these other horrible things would happen because I wasn't smart enough to pick up a language. Taking Spanish 1 was very difficult, and I thought I was going to fail it. But I ended up doing very well. And by the end of Spanish 1, I was able to read and the same thing with Spanish 2. It was very hard, but I ended up with a good grade and a better grade than in Spanish 1. But I had one major problem in my Spanish classes, and that was that I lacked the confidence to speak. I could read it and understand what I saw on the page, but I was afraid to speak. I was afraid that I didn't sound as natural as other students, and I knew I didn't sound confident. I never raised my hand in Spanish class. My Spanish teacher would call on me because I didn't raise my hand, and he really wanted me to learn, so he kept speaking to me in Spanish until I would answer him. But he had a class of 25 other students, and I was so embarrassed. I felt that everybody's eyes were on me, and I just wasn't good. And I would tell him sometimes, can't you go to another student who speaks better than I do? And I don't know where this fear came from. I do know that when I was younger, Spanish was provided in the school system when I was very young. And my Spanish teacher told me that I should keep going with Spanish because I was very good at Spanish. And I didn't believe her. And then I moved. And then about 4 years later, Spanish was provided again to me in the school system. And that teacher told me that I was very good at Spanish. And I didn't believe her. So somewhere along the line, I developed a fear of learning languages. And I think it's because I had a fear of looking stupid in front of other people, or inadequate in front of other people, because my whole life, people have been telling me what I can't do. And I have always managed to prove them wrong. But in order to prove people wrong, you have to be confident. And it's a lot easier to learn a language when you're younger. But it is very good for the brain to learn a language when you're older and adult. But I didn't want to be embarrassed, and that's why languages were so hard for me, because I had a fear of being embarrassed. Don't fear being embarrassed, guys. It will get in your way. Don't be embarrassed. When Spanish 2 was over in college, I was relieved, and I felt that I learned nothing, even though I got a good grade. I felt that I didn't retain anything. And then, about 2 months ago, I came across something on a website that was written in Spanish. And I understood about 95% of it. And at that moment, I decided that I was going to become a fluent Spanish speaker. And I'm very happy that I made that decision. For years, I feel that other people have wanted me to learn Spanish. Plenty of Spanish speakers have come up to me on the street and when I tell them that I don't speak Spanish, they don't believe me and they tell me to go ask my parents. So I guess some people think that I should know Spanish. Why I decided to learn Spanish now? Well, there are a few reasons. One reason I will tell you about in another video, but the main reason is because I lost my fear. I don't have a fear of it anymore. I don't have a fear of learning languages, of being embarrassed anymore. And that is a very freeing feeling. And I will tell you that if you are looking to build your confidence, learning something new can build your confidence. Learning a language right now at this time has given me so much confidence. I feel so good about myself just because I made this small decision to embrace another language. So if you are going through a difficult time and you need something to get your mind off things, learn something new because it will do a lot for your confidence and a lot for your life. I decided about 4 weeks ago that I was going to continue with the Spanish, and I cannot tell you how good I feel, how confident I feel as compared to 4 weeks ago. So get out there and learn something new. And if you're going through a rough time, I'm sorry. And hang in there and try to learn something new, because it can do a lot for your confidence and your self-esteem and your overall well-being, in my humble opinion. I will be right back with gameplay. Since I talked this episode about how learning and learning something new can build one's confidence, I thought that it would be a good time for the sim of Raphael Barba to learn a new skill. And he wants to impress Olivia, so he is going to pick up the baking skill. I had another idea, but I decided against it because Olivia and Raphael are in a group right now, and I didn't want Olivia to pick up the same skill that Raphael did. At least not at this point. So I will save the other skill for another episode. And he is going to make brownies. And Olivia will probably work out extra tomorrow. And he should be getting hungry soon. So he acquired a new skill, the baking skill. And I'm glad that Olivia is not joining him. Because I don't want her to know how to bake at this point. And Raphael is hungry. I like that when Sims bake, they put what they baked on a table and they don't just grab for it. Because sometimes my Sims grab for what they cooked, but I don't want them to yet. So they're going to grab a serving together. And these are normal quality, probably because he was confident. So they're going to eat brownies and talk. And when they talk, they will be improving their charisma skill. Discuss food flavors. That's something that Raphael would do. And he wants to make her laugh. So he's going to tell a funny story.
Fuba Torka Tribs.
Amanda's here. What did she smell? The brownies?
Kimba. Pivdra Voy. Stairs. Sonza Brista. Quit Pimbo. Picked up Frenzy. Kimba. Baina Flim. Crip.
I'm just going to pretend that Amanda is not here. And she's leaving. Thank you. He's going to have a deep conversation with her.
Forty photos of Bab.
Flazzle Pelka.
In the ops.
Ah, but you
and
me.
Give her a compliment.
His honest navy. Oompa free. Feneca Fenave. His beloved Grinica.
Four.
Oh. Back annoy. Oh.
Spurbic Zalga.
No. Oh. Does Miko's Ferenzi. Funchil Brossa. Bomb. Zopi. The bow. At Sick of Flash.
All right. Lenarga, maybe.
And. He's going to do something that could be construed as romantic, but not necessarily. Ask if single. I know it's under romance, but you can ask anyone if they're single. It doesn't necessarily mean that you're interested.
Ah, miss a dib.
Yeah, through ya. But here at Turinj, Fonobe. Obisha. Free Bono.
Pima. Blashu. Organor. Ulak Zerb. Zambas. Freeba. From. Ebony Flurba.
Descos? Kipora, the fool. Verobi Sapino? Chinobs, Balafoy. K. West.
And I'm going to end this episode here, guys. I hope that you enjoyed it as much as I enjoyed bringing it to you. Thank you so much for watching, and thank you for all of your support. Be happy.